Hello and welcome into Coach's Corner. Jordan Woodruff with you. And today we're joined by head coach of girls soccer, Mike Arnold. And good to have you along, Coach.
Thanks for letting me be here.
Yeah, and first year. You've been around Ponca for a while, but how's it in your first year coaching, head coaching?
It's a big change. It's going from being the assistant last year to the head coach and just all of the people you have to call, all the paperwork that goes into organizing, going to an event, but we have phenomenal parents with us. Our booster club is amazing, and it is a huge change.
Yeah, well, and one thing that's always fun with soccer, it's just like the other outdoor sports, especially in the spring. One day you're practicing and it's 70 degrees, and the next day you may have to go play a game, and all of a sudden it's 20 degrees outside. So I would imagine part of it's just keeping everybody motivated because the weather. I know when I played sports, the springtime, when I was standing out in left field and it was really cold, that was tough. So I imagine keeping motivation high is always important.
Well, we started in the off season. I mean, we had off season soccer during football season, and then even through Christmas. And so we've conditioned, we do practices, and then you get into February, or no, like our preseason starts in the middle of February, right around February 17th is when it starts. And we went 3 days because of being inside, trying to do conditioning inside because it was 11 degree wind chill. And the morale does get to you. I mean, the morale for the girls, like, do we have to practice? Like, yes. Yeah. Yes, just dress warm. But yeah, I mean, yesterday we went down to Putnam City West, and I put sunblock on because it was steamy. And the day before, I was wearing my beanie and hoodie out at practice. So yeah, the weather, just you don't know what you're gonna get. And comes, it's right at spring break. We got severe weather, so now you're gonna go, okay, are we gonna have lightning? Are we gonna have thunderstorms and whatnot? But it is what it is. You're just trying to figure out what you're gonna do to get by it.
Beauty of outdoor sports. Now, I want to ask you, and it's kind of two parts. I'll give you the first part, then we'll talk about the second. But when it comes to you now being a head coach, what is kind of the, I guess you'd say, philosophies you want to instill, the foundation you want to instill in what's now your program?
Well, we focus first that we have students first. They're a student before they're an athlete. And so Shelby Creatures is my assistant. We focus a lot on making sure that, are the kids going to class? Are we getting the grades? If they're struggling with a class, we look at how can we get them assistance? How can we get them help? Tutoring, just their basics. And then we go from there. We focus in on making it a team and being united as one. Our senior leaders wanted to do the Big Littles. So our juniors and seniors get a freshman and sophomore and kind of mentor them. And so a big key that we focus on the Wildcat way, we focus on work ethic is huge, and teamwork, because it is a team sport. So, I mean, the biggest thing that we want to get is a positive energy. I try to create as much positive energy as I can with my program. And then at the top also, winning. I mean, that's, you go by the numbers, and that's what you need. You need W's, not L's.
Right. And now that leads me to the second part is when you're looking at what you do on the field. So what are maybe some of the things that maybe you focus on as far as the game itself?
You got to get your formation, but ball touches. If we possess the ball, I teach the girls this, is if we possess the ball, the other team can't score. If we have it, they don't. And so we work on a lot on possession, on dribbling, on ball skills. And then, like I said, with our formation, we run a set formation, but every player is adaptive to where they know if this is the spot they go in and I need them to go into a different spot, they know that position. And so we focus a lot on our formation and just fundamentals, just your fundamental skills.
Yeah, and a lot of times on this level, just having the fundamentals is the difference in wins and losses in a big way. Those fundamentals in any sport, those are key, especially on this level.
Yeah, your first touch on the ball. In soccer, your first touch on the ball determines whether you're going to maintain the ball or if you can get dispossessed. You've got to be able to know where your team's going to go. We've got to be they've got to be able to work as a unit, because there's no one player that's going to win a game for you.
Yeah, and you mentioned earlier team sport. Soccer, to me, is one of the epitome of team sports because, you know, goaltender gets to stay in their box. Your strikers that are going to be scoring, that's part of what they do. You got somebody that's trying to make sure they can get the ball in the right spots. Then you got defenders that are hardly ever on the other side of the field. So soccer, you know, we talk about all sports with a role, but soccer really does define roles.
Yeah, you're, you know, the whole thing when I was explaining, like, their formation, you know, our defenders, you stay back. You're a defender. You're helping the keeper keep the ball out of the net. But if one of my defenders makes a run up, my midfielder knows he's went up, she needs to come back and protect. And they play their roles really well.
Yeah, so, and that's great, and that's what every coach asks for. You define roles, but also they have to accept those roles. So it sounds like they're doing that.
In soccer, you can't call a timeout.
Right.
I can't say, hold up, we got to talk yeah. about this over. You know, you sub someone in, someone out, or you just give redirection across the field.
Yeah, that's what's unique with soccer. It's like, you know, we hear the old saying, the hay's in the barn. Well, soccer, when the match starts, it's in the barn for 45 minutes, and then you come out in the next, you know, your next period. So the thing is, it's like you said, you can call out there and adjust, but as far as calling timeout and setting up a play, you don't get that luxury that other coaches get.
No, not at all.
So let's go through and talk a little bit about some of the key girls that you have this year, and, you know, you can go through your list and talk about their role and how important they are to this team this year.
Well, we have five seniors. Lindy Fisher, I'm going to go with names. Lindy Fisher, Lainey Reynolds, Katie Windham, Melissa, and the fifth one is Haley Creech. Haley and Lainey are, you know, they're all great girls. Haley, Lainey, and Melissa are more on our defensive side, and Katie and Lindy are midfield to forwards. They've got the knowledge. They control the middle and help with the attack. I mean, they're phenomenal on knowing the position and being able to read the game really well. In fact, one of them came up to me and was like not having an issue, but a girl was faster than her, and she was like, "Hey, I can't keep up with her. You know, let me know." It's like, we need to do something here. And it was really amazing because she's like, she saw that this needed to be, you know, tweaked. It was like, boom, we did it. With juniors, we've got Adrena. Oh, God, you're going to put me trying to think of the rest of them. We have, like, five juniors. We have a small upperclassman, and we have a large freshman sophomores coming in. We've got a pretty good, solid sophomore group. And the juniors and sophomores that are coming in have worked really well with our seniors to make this program be successful.
Well, that's very good. And it's here. I mean, the schedule is here. It's going to be you're going to be at it pretty much every week now going forward.
Next week, season starts, like today is opening. You know, it's open season. It's like deer hunting.
Yeah.
Today is when season starts. We have three games, or we have three events next week. We have Enid here, and which we have two JV games and two varsity games. Then our JV teams go to Alva on Thursday, and then we travel Friday and Saturday to Choctaw for a varsity tournament.
Wow.
And so we've had three preseason events. We went to Stillwater for a 9v9, and then we went back to Stillwater for 11v11, and then we went last night to Putnam City West for JV and varsity.
Yeah, and you've had a lot of, I guess you'd say, sharpening the edge before you get out there on the field.
Well, and it seemed like we haven't, our practices, you know, we practice, we don't get the full field on a practice, so it's like seeing them practice is on the shorter side. We play like 7v7 or 9v9, so seeing them actually out there with the full 11 is like kind of tweaking where I want to put position, like where I'm going to position starters or what subs are going to be going in. And to see it, like last night at Putnam City West, the JV won 7-0 and the varsity tied 1-1, but it gave me a lot of insight on, hey, this person needs to be here.
Yeah.
And so come Tuesday, we'll see how it works.
Well, and I think the last thing to mention, like we said, the season is full going for this team. So we got this starting. But what are, in your first year here, what are, as a head coach, what are your expectations for this team? And let's just, it's a tough district. I mean, when you look at how the districts are set up, 6A, most sports are very unforgiving when you look at the top of those districts.
Looking at our schedule and looking at the district we're in, we can make the playoffs. There's not a doubt in my mind that we can't make the playoffs.
And that's the top four make the playoffs in a district, correct?
And, you know, I'd love to get a home field. I'd love to get a first round playing here, and just it would just be a big incentive for our community.
Well, and it's been quite a while since I think Ponca's got to host, boys or girls, host.
I mean, back when the last time I remember them making the playoffs, I can't think of the year, but I reffed it.
Wow.
It's been quite a few years.
Well, Ponca's had a lot of luck doing that with football, so let's see if they can do it with football. Yeah,
let's carry on from the oval ball to the round one, and let's go.
Yeah, no doubt. Well, Coach, anything else before we let you go?
No, I appreciate you coming down and helping us do this.
No, I appreciate you being on here, and we'll see you out there on the field. Let's go get them this season, and yeah, let's make that goal. Let's not just get to playoffs. Let's host when it's all said and done.
Yeah, that'd be awesome.
That'd be an awesome first year for you and a great accomplishment for these girls. And we've seen a lot of stuff over the past months really happen here in Ponca City as far as first, going from swimming. Got a two-time state champion in wrestling. You had football hosting playoffs. So there's been a lot of stuff going on here in Ponca City as far as that regard. So maybe soccer will be the next to do something like that. All right, that's going to do it. I want to say thanks to Coach Mike Arnold, and we'll catch you next time for our next edition of Coach's Corner. Jordan Woodruff saying so long, and go Cats!